set on the turquoise waters of Pirate's Cove. It's time to lower the Jolly Roger. Just remember, at every end is a new beginning. A beginning filled with wonder and excitement for all who dare to make the voyage. For all who dare to take that first step in search of their dreams.
We got two tunes.
For within each and every one of us lies a pirate of our own. Filled with the same adventurous spirit and that same uncontrollable wanderlust, all on the same journey, seeking out our own treasure, our own silver and gold. So hold on tightly to the wheel, raise the mainsail, check your compass, and point your ship in the direction you want to go, and sail along with us in pursuit of the never-ending dream, ladies and liner lovers, the 24 karat gold Pirates of the Caribbean Pyramid Team. Now for today's show, me first mate, couldn't do it without him, say hello to Micah. Now as our skiers around the final corner, high and dry behind Captain Al and those 400... Now me and me cutthroat crew have dropped anchor out in Pirate's Cove after a long and, dare I say, prosperous voyage. While we come ashore seeking refuge and to deposit our vast amounts of ill-gotten wealth, otherwise known as treasure, in the banks of this here deserted tropical island. In fact, out to the starboard side, I spy one of me boats bounding in over the Brawny Brew with a barefoot buccaneer behind, lads and lasses. Say hello to Rick with a prayerful tumble.
Hey, everybody. Say hello to the conventional doubles team.
Why, those crazy cannonballs will stop at nothing. Take it. Headed our way. The lower heads are still on straight. Once again, let's welcome back to the main stage our unconventional, conventional doubles couple. And follow at 3 o'clock. That's 3 o'clock p.m. Please come back and see us for the last time. Right now, what I want everybody to do in the audience, if you could all put your hands together, Captain Al and those 450 seahorses need a little help with 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. We've got 18 skiers off the dock, and they're up and in.
I don't think they have enough.
Waters of Pirate's Cove. Why, it's time to lower the Jolly Roger, pull up the anchor, and raise the mainsail. Now, just remember, at every end is a new beginning. A beginning filled with wonder and excitement for all who dare to make the voyage. For all who dare to take that first step in search of their dreams. For within each and every one of us lies a pirate of our own. Filled with the same adventurous spirit and the same uncontrollable wanderlust, all on the same journey, seeking out our own treasure, our own silver and gold. So point your ship in the direction you want to go. Check the mainsail, raise the main mast. Check your compass, point your ship in the direction you want to go, and sail with us up into the pursuit of the never-ending dream. That never-ending adventure that we call life. The ladies and land lovers, I get to you, the Pirates of the Caribbean 24 karat gold pyramid team. Let's bring him up to the main stage one more time, just for you. Let him hear it. Oh, once again, the Pirates of the Caribbean 24 karat gold pyramid team.
Dance a lot, you know the dance.
We're going to be fucking right, we're going to be 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 right
Thank you. while plotting a course that just creators a rogue tighter than a knot. Guaranteed to make a fool out of the wisest man. I see eight rogues in a row, still out of the dead man's chest. Barefoot line. Why don't you know those men are so quick? They're even fast asleep. From one end to the other, let's put our hands together once again as they come by the main stage. The dead man's chest, barefoot line. Tropical paradise is about to give up one of her best kept secrets. Point your eyes to the port side, if and you will, where you'll see a smorgasbord of succulents, appealing to the eye as well as the palate. Why, I'd have to say they're the catch of the day, the seafood buffet. Keeping a tight grip on those vines behind Captain Al and those 450 seahorses in front of that hydrodyne. Well, what say we all get behind them as they prepare to cast off once again the Island Girls of the West Indies. Laura, Kendra, and gig, why, if it isn't none other than the Honorable Admiral Cougar Pines of the British Royal Navy scouring the seascape for none other than yours truly. Well, now the Admiral has let it be known that he knows the sea better than most men, so let's have a look and see just exactly what he meant. That's Admiral Cougar Pines giving us a lesson in higher mentality. Army Majors, look seaward again. Why, it's none other than Captain Cliffhanger, and it looks to me like he's ready to set sail on a regular carnival cruise, slicing through the water like the fin of a shark and keeping us right on the edge. And finally, the last man in this Admiral Ship of Fools sailing by in another one of those water blades, raising the mainsail to new heights. Why, it's none other than the Rear Admiral himself. Bend over, looking back and forth in search of yours truly. Well, at any rate, it seems so far so good. They've seen nothing of what they was looking for. I think the Admiral and his men have spun so many circles, they've somehow mistaken me for a palm tree. But wait! It's Admiral Cougar Pines passing by for another look. Pointing his stern into the wind and going down into Davy Jones's locker. And as they round the pirate posse down there at the end of Pirate's Cove, they're both going, no, not me, not to me, I don't want to go first. Meantime, I'd like to take just a second to thank up in our concession stand. We got Mary Jo, Deb, and Megan tonight. Let's hear it for them. Well, float my boat. Why, it's none other than the Rear Admiral himself. 1 foot on that pair of shoe skis. They're a very difficult and tricky maneuver. Still in search of something. However, we're not quite sure. And speaking of soaring to new heights, watch closely as Captain Cliff readjusts his latitude and prepares to adjust himself or readjust himself into space. Watch closely, folks, as he comes into that wink, upside down, and into the drink. Well, in the meantime, let's give a big pirate welcome, if you will, to none other than the Honorable Admiral Cougar Pines. I usually bring it up the rear, but not quite in this case. It's the Rear Admiral himself coming in for a closer look. Turn around, me bucko. There you go. Say hello to the Rear Admiral, Ben Dover. And out on the waters of Pirate's Cove. He can hear you all the way out there in the cove, you guys. Let him hear it. Captain Cliffhanger. Well, once again, the high-flying, rainbow-riding man of the British Royal Navy.
Captain Kidd, hold fast and stand your ground, you wretched sea worm.
Not so fast, Mr. Pine Tree. Oh, by the way, I really like that wretched sea worm line. That was good stuff, man.
The reward for your capture is great, kid. I intend to bring you in dead or alive, so surrender peacefully or die trying.
Not so fast, Mr. Pine Tree. Would you be interested in a slight wager? You and one of the Queen's finest sailors against two of me most despicable henchmen in a feet-to-feet fight to the finish. If you win, I'll surrender peacefully or die trying. But if I win, or my men wins, I'm free to see the dawn of a new day. Agreed?
Agreed, kid. But tell me, my good man, why not you and one of your henchmen instead of not you, but two of your henchmen?
Arr, matey, I can't swim a stroke. And besides, I don't want to break a nail. Cast their lines out to the mainmast, all to a position themselves. On top of these beautiful bronze beaches, all two men, ready to head out to see what they're made of. Now watch closely as our ship sets sail. Watch closely as all two slide off the beach into the waters of Pirate's Cove, standing on nothing but their bare feet. Arr, me bucko, it looks like I might have to surrender peacefully. Why, this had to look of an epic two-man brawl, but we're going to send it down to a one-man brawl. Two bare feet crossing the cove, boldly going where no foot has gone before. Why, it looks like he's rounding the last corner. Why, it looks to me like the ham is in the oven, but wait. I think he's gone loopy. He's coming in. Once again, lads and lasses, if you will, let's give it up. Let him hear it, Admiral Cooper Pines. Well, to the victors go the spoils, and since we've dueled to a draw, I declare myself the winner. Yay. Don't have a lot of support, do I?
No, I should have been the good guy.
Aye, carumba, polyester, me fear's the worst. For I hear the native ritual drums. Oh. Chief Kamanawana and his tribe of headhunters, the most feared tribe of headhunters to ever hunt a head. Why, it sounds to me like it could be open season on anything up above the shoulders. Now listen up, polyester, you better button up that beak so we don't ruffle any tail feathers or we don't fight end up like a chicken with its head cut off. In fact, I see some hungry headhunters right there. And it looks like they're ready to head off into the wild blue in search of their two-eyed, blue-eyed trophies. They be the conventional doubles. Why, those crazy cannonballs will stop at nothing to get ahead. And following up, why, it looks like we have our tribe of trios. As they maneuver themselves out over on the main rock behind Scott, Captain Scott Davis, and those 200 Evan Root horses on that Hydrodyne. I think that's a 200 horse. I'm not sure. Say hello, everybody, to our tribe of trios team. And finally, the last of our primitive primates head out into the waters of Pirate's Gulf. Why, it's none other than our strap doubles couple. Give him a hand. Say hello to our strap doubles, couples. From head to toe and all points in between, the headhunter, conventional doubles, trios, and strap doubles, couples. Glad everybody can make it tonight. It's certainly good to see everybody right now. We're going to take a short intermission. We're going to be set secret ceremonial dance. Now watch closely as the ancient dance of the fly.
I told the witch doctor I was in love with you. I told the witch doctor I was in love with you.
The chief, come on, Iwana.
And the witch doctor.
And his lovely wife, Tween, I'm on to get out of here.
Doctor, you didn't love me true.
I clap along if you would.
You didn't love me nice. And then the witch doctor, he gave me this advice. He said that, oh, my friend, the witch doctor, he taught me what to say. My friend, the witch doctor, he taught me what to do. I know that you'll be mine when I say this to you.
Sure to make headlines in the local jungle paper. Chief Manawana, Queen Ivana, get out of here and strap ahead on. Why, sure as the trade winds blow, the smell of mutiny is in the air. Mutiny, my musket falls down my book. If you're a mutineer, you won't live to read the next chapter. Well, I'll bear me cutlass and I'll cut him in three. Well, what do you know? I haven't even drawn me sword yet, and already I see three of me cowardly crew members all ready to jump ship. A single helicopter with a double cross down below. Well, blow me down if it isn't the Admiral and his men once again in hot pursuit of those wayward sailors of mine. Now, this next display of acrobatic airmanship is a three-man nautical nightmare guaranteed to make the toughest man forget to remember. Ladies and gentlemen, it looks like all three have the main rigging pulled behind their back. Well, made a CB in their veins with transmarial pirouettes. Well, it looks like there's motion in the ocean now, out there on the liquid lagoon, high above the coral reefs. Why, the Admiral and his men have tossed the three mutineers into the brig, and it looks like they're headed on their way back to the mothership for reinforcements. Army Bucko! We can let them hear it out there on the cove as they stand by the mothership. Toss out one extra main rigging to pick up another man in the Admiral Ship of Fools. Well, it looks like Captain Al's got his hands full trying to find the end of the main rigging, and there it is. I think once they take off and come by, we should give them a big yo-ho. Are you with me? Yes, all right, me buckles. Here we go. I'm going to give you to the count of three. One, two, and three, yo, ho, ho, and they're up. Well, let's give them a big pirate wave as they come by. That's once again as Captain Al in front of those 450 seahorses with the Admiral and his crew. Now, if you will, it seems to me the key to their success is adapting to the situation. Never give up. Never say never. Why, that is their quest. Nothing less than the ultimate effort, and now their ultimate challenge. All four men take the main rigging and pull it around behind their back. All four men are wrapped and ready to rotate. Well, me buckos, picture this. Each jump ski is 6 feet long, end to end. We're going to take 24 feet of twisting, turning, pirouetting ski across a jump ramp that is only 14 feet wide. A very dangerous and difficult maneuver. Why, there ain't no room for error, because there ain't no room, period. Shoulder to shoulder, hip to hip, knee to knee, ski to ski, the synchronization of four men, 450 seahorses, and 24 feet of twisting, turning ski. Why, it ain't gonna fit. Why, float my boat! back in over the bounding main up to the main stage so that we can all make their acquaintance. Let them hear it. They can hear you out there on the call, folks. Coming up to main stage right now. Say hello to these two ship jumpers. Say hello to Tony and Mike. And those four men coming in on those six skis. It's the Admiral and his crew with the quad 360 helicopter spins. Let's hear it for Bill, Mark, Matt, and Nate. Oh, once again, the Pirates of the Caribbean jump team. Let me pull up my pantyhose. Well, now that things are calming down a bit, maybe me and me crew can catch up on a little well-deserved shut-eye. After all, that's why we came to this island. This is a hammock. A little R&R, if you will. A little bit of rest and relaxation. There she blows! Fortify the battlements. Man your battle station. Sound the battle cry. Put some balls in your muskets. Prepare for combat. Fight the good fight. For the enemy is at hand. The enemy is afoot. The enemy! Where is the enemy? Well, holy volcano, the main rock seems to be blowing its top. Why, I see a buildup of molten lava spewing up all over, not one peak, but two, and it looks like those peaks are about to blow! Spectacular! Look at the size of that thing! All right. Well, what goes up eventually comes down. And as the ashes settle and the dust clears, once again, our volcanoes have grown peaceful and quiet, only to erupt sometime in the unforeseeable future. Well, with the ocean waves lapping at their shores and the wind sweeping slowly across their landscape, why, I think it's time that we have a closer look at our very own volcanic wonders. Let them hear it as they come in over Pirate's Cove up to the main stage. Once again, the builders of our prefabricated volcanoes. Same one. You've heard it. Laugh when you're supposed to laugh, okay? As nobody else will. A sailor meets a pirate in a bar. The pirate has a peg leg, a hook, and an eye patch. How'd you end up with that wood leg, mate? Asked the sailor. Well, I was swept overboard in a storm, and a shark bit off me whole leg, said the pirate. Well, how'd you get that metal hook? Asked the sailor. I got lost during a sword fight I did. A scoundrel cut off me bloody hand. Unbelievable, said the sailor. Well, how'd you get that patch on your eye? Well, I was up in the crow's nest day, and I looked up, and a seagull dropping fell in me eye, said the pirate. Well, how'd that make you blind? Asked the sailor. Well, matey, it was the first day with me hook. I can tell that joke because I'm wearing pantyhose, so. The heat of those volcanoes threw out more heat than 100 100-watt lanterns. Why, with that and the heat of the sun scorching down on my furrowed brow, why, it's enough to make the ice in these old veins turn to water. Why, I fear that very heat has given me the island fever, for my head is beginning to swim in a sea of hallucination. Why, in fact, Over on the main rock, I see what appears to be a mermaid. And judging by the way her seahorse is headed, I do believe she's going to take a dip. Say hello to Shauna. And fresh from the waters of Pirate's Cove, behind Captain Al Brown on that ship we call Nautique, this would be Holly. And finally, over on the main rock, the last of our beauties from the sea. Say hello, if you will, to Janet. As we watch with wide-eyed wonder the grace and the splendor of Swivel Ski. Like the festivities have already begun. Say hello, if you will, to Mark and Kelly. And Tonight, coming in from Portside once again, fresh from the waters of Pirate's Cove. Say hello, let them hear it out there on the cove. They can hear you, Matt and Lauren. Now back over on the main rock. Why, it looks to me like Mark and Kelly are about to team up to stand as tall as a ship's crow's nest behind Captain Al. Let's send them off in style with a front attitude start. This is Mark and Kelly. And finally, once again, coming in from the left, let's raise the black flag one more time. A big pirate welcome. Say hello, if you will, to Rick and Janet. If you will, for Matt and Lauren. And washing up on shore, right behind, with a smile on their face. This would be Mark and Kelly. And the last of our trio of devils from the sea is just getting off the city dock. Let them hear it, folks, as they come around the corner, because they don't know you're going to applaud for them. So applaud for them anyway, would you? Yeah, they did a nice job out there. Well, let's raise old Jolly Roger one more time for Matt and Lauren, Mark and Kelly, and Rick and Janet, harnessing away like their forefathers before them, our star doubles couples. Arr. Me matey, why it's Chief Kamanawana and his tribe of headhunters. Where be me crew when I need them? Well, it looks like the end is near. Could be the end of my hand, the end of my hand, or just the end, period. Hey, strike swiftly, Chief. Suffer me not. Did I say that too soon?
His rope. But wait, he of the fleetest to beat in my fleet is about to make a barefoot getaway out into the cove. He's up. He's still up as he waits for the main rigging to tighten. He's up. He's down. He's up. He's under. He's out of sight. Going once. Going twice. You're out of there.
Did they tackle him in the water?
Yep, raising the mainsail. Why, it looks to me like that. Hey, Jean Lafitte, would you like to try that one more time there, me matey? What do you say, me buckos? You want to see that one more time? All right. With a little bit of encouragement, I think we might be able to talk the barefoot pirate into one more pass behind Captain Al and those 450 seahorses. But first, they must have a conference. Conference call. There it is. Ryder Jones throws in the rope. And now he's ready, he's prepared. He is mentally ready to attack the backwards flying dock start. As the main rigging tightens once again, let's see if we can't give him a send-off, ladies and gentlemen. Let him hear it as he heads out into the cove. Once again, he's down. He's up. Pull it in. He's backwards, barefoot. Now they say in this man's navy, 2 feet equal 24 inches, and judging by the looks of our barefoot buccaneer, I'd have to agree.
Wyatt. Looks like he's around in third and headed for home beach. Ladies and gentlemen, from the watchers of the world to the beaches and beyond, let's give it up. Hey, I'm getting that one-up signal. And it looks like he's going to try to do it one more time around the cove, which would make 4 feet of 48 inches. Why, it looks like he's in a classic struggle between good and not so good, between himself. Me first mate, as he said, he is rounded second. He's on the other side of the cove, but believe me, ladies and gents, when I tell you he can hear you all the way out there. Once again, that would be Jean Lafitte, the barefoot pirate. Going where no foot has gone before. I thought he was going to bring that one in all the way around. Hey, Tracy. Is anybody doing that boat thing? Nobody tells me anything. I have to find out. Oh, it's all set? All right. Be sinking.
Help me, Captain Kidd. I can't swim.
Arr, matey. You own your own ship, and you can't swim. Well, now that sounds familiar.
I'll grant you and your men a full pardon if you get me to shore. So come on, throw me a line.
Well, let's see, a full pardon for me and me men. Hey, if I can, let's see, throw you a line. How about this, baby? I love you.
No, no, no. Throw me a rope, you idiot. Throw me a rope.
Oh, you said you wanted me to throw you a rope. Well, me matey, let me see. Throw me the other one. Hurry up. There.
You nincompoop. Just get me to shore. Get me to shore.
Well, you said your back is sore?
No.
Oh, your butt is sore. Well, Admiral, you shouldn't sit around so much. I tell you what, why don't you just hop out of your dinghy and walk to shore? It's only about 1 foot deep. Well, Admiral, I believe you owe me and me crew a little something.
Do you, Captain Kidd, solemnly swear never again to kidnap and ravage and rifle and loot, to pillage and plunder and not give a hoot, so help you?
I do.
By the power vested in me by the state of Wisconsin, I now grant you, Captain Kidd, a full and unconditional pardon.
You may clap for me now! Ah, yes, all's well that ends well. Hey, me mateys, are you having fun so far? All right. Right now. Man, that dinghy went a long ways out there. Must be a crosswind out there in the cove, eh? Right now, what I want you to do, mates, if we can, as we get ready to take off with our grand pyramid, I want everybody to put their hands together. Let's see if we can't give Captain Al Zelder. We got 450 seahorses. We got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. We're looking at 20 water skiers on the water. Let's give them a little help as they prepare to take off. Make some noise, if you will. There it is. Hold on to it, hold on to it, yes. The little white rope, did it sink? The little white rope sank? See, you're asking the wrong person. Everybody up here saw it. Straight out there. Now, me mates, once again, as the sun sets over the turquoise waters of Pirate's Cove, why, it's time to lower the Jolly Roger, raise the anchor, and raise the mainsail. Now, just remember, as we prepare to cast off, at every end is a new beginning. A beginning filled with wonder and excitement for all who dare to make the voyage, for all who dare to take that first step in search of their dreams. For within each and every one of us lies a pirate of our own, filled with the same adventurous spirit and the same uncontrollable wanderlust, all on the same journey, seeking out our own treasure, our own silver and gold. So hold on tightly to the wheel, Raise the main mast, check your compass, and point your ship in the direction you want to go and sail off with us into the sunset. Lads and lasses, the Pirates of the Caribbean 24 karat gold pyramid team. And now, over to the port side out on the main dock. Say hello to the remaining skiers of the Pirates of the Caribbean. Give them a hand. Nice job, you guys. And I'd like to introduce you to the 2000 number one rated Wisconsin docking equipment. Well, let's make one last big splash, if you will, for the Pirates of the Caribbean 24 karat gold pyramid team. It looks like the problems are solved. What I want everybody to do right now, let's put our hands together and get behind the Grand Pyramid as they prepare to take off. We've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20 skiers, minus 450 seahorses. Ahoy, mateys! Try that again. You say ahoy. Ahoy, mateys! All right, let's do that one more time. Ahoy, mateys! All right, you guys are good. Once again, as the sun begins to set over the turquoise waters of Pirate's Cove, it's time to lower the Jolly Roger, pull up the anchor, and raise the mainmast. Now just remember, as we prepare to cast off, at every end is a new beginning. A beginning filled with wonder and excitement. The never-ending adventure that we call life. Ladies and gentlemen, I give to you the Pirates of the Caribbean 24 karat gold pyramid team.
Thank you.
go. Let them hear it. We're going to need all the help we can get, you guys. And there it is. Once again, as the sun sets over the turquoise waters of Pirate's Cove, it's time to lower the Jolly Roger, pull up the anchor, and raise the mainsail. Now just remember, at every end is a new beginning. A beginning filled with wonder and excitement for all who dare to make the voyage, for all who dare to take that first step in search of their dream. For within each and every one of us lies a pirate of our own, filled with the same adventurous spirit and that same adventurous wanderlust, all on the same journey, seeking out our own treasure, our own silver and gold. So hold on tightly to the reins, for then we call life. Ladies and landlubbers, I give to you the Pirates of the Caribbean 24 karat gold pyramid key. Let's bring him up to the main stage one more time, just for you. Once again. I'll be seeing you soon.
Really bad.